So, good evening, and welcome to the Chinook Chamber Singers Spring Concert. We're glad you made it here, and we're also delighted to share this concert with the Cantrice Women's Ensemble from Cardston, third director of Cardston. So, we're looking forward to hearing them in the second set here. We open this concert with an unfinished work by Henry Purcell, who is often considered the greatest English composer. In fact, he was so highly regarded that he was buried beside the organ in Westminster Abbey. This music, followed by a number of blank pages, was found after his death, and it was immediately obvious that this was the opening section of a larger work. So, as beautiful as this fragment is, we can only guess what the entire work may have sounded. We will sing another Purcell piece in this concert, but first we'd like to step back approximately 84 years and share a work with you by the great Belgian composer Philippe de Monte. De Monte lived to a very old age at the time, of 82, and appears to have spent every waking moment composing. 1,200 madrigals, 14 masses, 260 motets and sacred works. So it's non-stop. Laudate Domini, this one that we're singing, is a late work of the sacred motet category and is a beautiful setting of Psalm 150 set for two choirs.
Bye.
We have a lot of different styles of music we're performing tonight, so there's a fair bit of on-stage choreography. So, as indicated in your program, our second Purcell piece comes from his famous opera, Diogenes. And it is the famous lament aria, which Dido sings at the loss of her betrothed. It's an achingly beautiful aria, and as everyone who has ever taken an introductory music course will know, it is made even more melancholy by the use of a descending ground bass. Now, a ground bass is a technique by which the composer uses the same bass melodic pattern over and over again while writing variations above it. And you will hear this piece opened by the bassist singing this melodic pattern. But if you listen carefully, you will continue to hear it repeat over and over throughout the entire piece. Perhaps not always in the bass voice, but usually in the lowest voice that's singing at that time. Oscar Horowitz taught composition at the University of Toronto from 1952 until about 1982. And so he created this beautiful choral arrangement of this aria, When I Am a Maiden.
Thank you.
one of Canada's most renowned composers, Huey Willen, created more than 800 musical works in a wide variety of genres, including, well, but primarily organ and sacred choral works, symphonies. He did a lot of that stuff, but mostly organ and sacred choral works. He was no slouch. He was commissioned to write the anthem for the coronation of Queen Elizabeth II. He was the first non-British person to ever receive Lambeth Doctorate from the Archbishop of Canterbury. And this next piece that we're performing was actually performed in 1952 at the New Royal Festival Hall, in front of or before the future Queen Elizabeth and Prince Philip. So he's kind of big. An Apostrophe to the Heavenly Hosts is Willen's choral masterpiece, and it includes two full choirs, two offstage mystic choruses, has enormous proportions in terms of voicing and dynamics and range. The text is taken from Eastern Orthodox Christian liturgy and is an invitation by mortals to the three ranks of heavenly beings, and it's an invitation to join the mortals in praise of the eternal Trinity. The two choirs, represent the mortals. So whenever you hear the choir singing, that's representing the mortals. And they address that would decimate our choir. Instead, it will be soloists from within the choir. You hear them as individual voices, and you recognize that as the mystic chorus. So I hope you enjoy this piece.
Thank you. wonderful facility. Each of these ladies behind me are friends in music. We're all here because we love to sing. To begin with this evening, we have Sesame Madrigals. The beginning one, that was the month of May, we thought was perfect for the beginning of May, so we'd like to begin with that. And lucky me, sometimes they let me sing with them.
Thank you.
sing with Ann Campbell Singers as I was growing up and traveling and touring and sing. And then Dr. George Evelyn, who I loved with all my heart, was so encouraging to me at a time when I needed encouragement and has always been there to answer my phone calls, even if they're kind of silly questions. But I pay tribute to him tonight and thank him very much. He just loved his music.
People say the magic's done. No more of that. People say the magic's done. No more of that.
was talking about this group, is everything creates their own love and their own background of what they've done. Our first one down in the Lethbridge Parade, this actually comes from a King Singers edition of that, wonderful tune, and that was about, followed by Wonder for the World, and featuring Abigail Bennett and Christina Ray as our girls.
Thank you.
Brian Tate. He is a Canadian composer of our time right now, and lucky us as Canadians, we have such a beautiful, rich heritage of Pearl music that is now being written in the last decade or two. And our group, we really like to highlight Canadian arrangers and composers. We'll be back with Brian Tate.
Thank you.
It comes to us from Mexico, and I think it's about New York.
Thank you.
That was wonderful. Thank you so much. It was a real treat. So we'd like to begin our second set with a piece by Mendelssohn, who belongs to that group of unfortunate composers like Purcell and Mozart, who died at a very young age. Mendelssohn was 38, and yet, like Purcell and Mozart, in his brief life he composed some of the greatest music ever heard. This piece was composed when he was 21 years old. I think I was just learning to walk at that time. It's just incredible to think of the kind of training in the background that can produce a piece like this. It's set for male chorus and female chorus, and it's used in Lutheran texts. So one of the things about Mendelssohn is that he always writes very well for the voice. It fits. It's not easy to sing, but it fits, and we've really enjoyed rehearsing it. Hopefully we can share some of that with you.
Thank you. This number is the one.